Trey Gowdy has been a central figure in the Russian investigation. The South Carolina lawmaker has helped ferret out evidence proving the deep state and FBI launched a biased investigation against Donald Trump. But Gowdy just said two things that turned the investigation upside down. During an appearance on CBS's Face the Nation, Gowdy was quizzed by host Margaret Brennan about the House conservatives' push to impeach Deputy Attorney General Rod Rosenstein for carrying out a cover-up to protect the FBI's secrets about their conduct in the 2016 election. Gowdy responded, "Number, for what? Impeach him for what? Number." Brennan then pushed Gowdy to respond to the efforts made by Freedom Caucus Chairman Mark Meadows of North Carolina and Ohio Congressman Jim Jordan to impeach Rosenstein. Gowdy waved it away, stating, "I'm not convinced there is a movement." Finally, Gowdy tried to stake out ground that revealed him as a skeptic of Rosenstein, but not a deep state apologist. The South Carolina lawmaker explained, "I've had my differences with Rod Rosenstein. I talk to him quite often privately, which again is a lot more constructive than the public hearings we have," Gowdy concluded. Gowdy also contradicted President Trump after his press conference with Vladimir Putin. The South Carolina lawmaker rebutted Trump's statement that since the Democrats never allowed their server to be investigated, there was no way to prove who was behind the cyber attacks in 2016. Gowdy wrote, "Russia is not our friend. Russia attempted to undermine the fundamentals of our democracy, impugn the reliability of the 2016 election, and sow the seeds of discord among Americans. Our intelligence community, including the current one, concluded this, as did the Majority House Intelligence Committee report, as did our fellow Americans. WHO served on grand juries which returned true bills on two separate occasions. I am confident former CIA Director and current Secretary of State Mike Pompeo, DNI Dan Coats, Ambassador Nikki Haley, FBI Director Chris Wray, Attorney General Jeff Sessions and others will be able to communicate to the President. It is possible to conclude Russia interfered with our election in 2016 without delegitimizing his electoral success." Trump supporters were puzzled by Gowdy's comments. Gowdy has been the tip of the spear in the fight to uncover how the FBI used the Christopher Steele Russia dossier, which was paid for by Hillary Clinton and the Democrats, as the basis for obtaining a FISA warrant against Carter Page. And Gowdy grilled disgraced FBI agent Peter Strzok about his blatant anti-Trump bias in the Russian and Clinton email investigations. Rosenstein has been slow-walking document requests made by Congress, which many conservatives believe amounts to obstruction of justice. The only way to force Rosenstein to obey the rule of law is for Congress to take action with teeth behind it. But Gowdy kneecapped those efforts by claiming he doesn't support impeachment. And Gowdy missed the point of Trump's Russia comments. In his press conference, Trump clearly stated he had confidence in his intelligence officials. But he was not going to allow the media to collude with the Democrats to press this conspiracy theory that his campaign coordinated with Moscow to rig the election. The accusations against Russia detail very small social media ad buys on Facebook and Twitter that pushed out propaganda for both sides of the political spectrum. Their efforts had zero effect on any votes in the election. But the media doesn't care. Their only goal is to trap Trump into admitting on the global stage that his election was rigged and he is not the rightful president of the United States. Do you agree? Let you know your thoughts in the comment section.